Mamata Banerjee is not running a government in West Bengal. She is running a mafia. This mafia is a danger to the country's internal security. It is a danger to the state's economy, and it has already proven to be a danger to the security and welfare of the state's women and youth. Today I visited Mathurapur, and for literally kilometers I could see infiltrators, hutments and tenements on both sides of the roads. And TMC government has been providing these infiltrators with Aadhaar card, ration card, voter ID card, and has been endangering the internal security of the country. There has been a demographic change in so many villages, so many districts of West Bengal, only to increase and protect the vote bank of the TMC. And this government, after 2011, has added 71 castes to the OBC lists. Of these 71 castes, 65 castes belong to Muslim denominations. This just indicates the extent to which an assault has been made not only on the demography of the state but also on the constitution of India. This is the kind of battle that people of West Bengal are facing. On one hand, the economy of India is growing at a fast pace due to the Prime Minister's leadership. On the other hand, West Bengal is rapidly getting deindustrialized. West Bengal in the last 5 years figures among the state that has attracted the least amount of foreign direct investments. Young people from the state are forced to migrate to different cities seeking job opportunities. And this state, which was once considered to be the pioneer on all dimensions in India, it was said that what Bengal thinks today, India thinks tomorrow. This state has been reduced to this kind of a morass because of TMC's and Mamata Banerjee's leadership. I am very confident that this time around the youth of West Bengal will vote in massive numbers for the BJP and the Prime Minister's leadership and will lift this state out of the morass that the TMC has taken.
If you like this video, then like, share and subscribe to ET Now.